In 2005, there was Operation Duryodhan. It exposed 11 MPs wanting money to ask questions in the Indian Parliament. In 2005, there was also Operation Chakravyuh. It exposed the misuse of MP Lad funds by MPs. In 2008, there was the Cash for Votes scam, where the BJP MPs brought cash into the Parliament, claiming that it had been offered to them for buying their votes in the no confidence motion. For many Indians, the Indian Parliament is the biggest symbol of our 66-year-old democracy. It is the place where MPs and our political parties negotiate amongst themselves the future of our peoples. For the sake of our democracy, our MPs have to be representing their constituencies fairly and without hidden agendas. If some don't, it casts doubt on an institution all of us Indians have invested so much in. Over the past year, Cobra Post has exposed 11 members of the Parliament from various political parties such as Congress, BJP, BSP, JDU and AIADMK, who agreed to issue letters of recommendation for a non-existent foreign company for a hefty cash amount. From six of those MPs, Cobra Post even has letters in its possession, duly signed by these respected members of Parliament. Cobra Post undercover reporter Kumar Ashish presents himself as an agent for a fictitious company by the name of Mediterranean Oil Inc. He meets a number of brokers who are ready to introduce him to several MPs who are known to exchange favors for cash. The undercover reporter thus has easy access to these MPs. He tells them that Mediterranean Oil Inc. was applying to the Petroleum Ministry for permission to explore and extract oil in the northeastern parts of India. He further tells them that the company needs letters of recommendation from members of Parliament to strengthen its profile for the application. In addition to the letters, the company will also need the MP's personal presence for active lobbying.
The undercover investigation revealed some shocking facts. Without any investigation into the credentials of the foreign company, the MPs issued signed letters of recommendation. They agreed to actively lobby for the cause of the foreign company. They asked for obscene amounts ranging between 50,000 rupees to 50 lakh rupees for the favor. Sometimes they would use middlemen to negotiate the amount, and at other times directly talk money. They offered to organize similar letters of recommendation from other MPs, thus suggesting a shady nexus between these members of Parliament when it came to making a quick buck.
The ease with which this operation was conducted almost leads us to the conclusion that accepting cash for favors is a routine matter for these MPs. What is most ironic is that these are the very same parties, some of which are in opposition, that disrupted the Parliament session protesting the regulation on FDI. And outside the Parliament, these MPs will not bat an eyelid while endorsing a foreign company to set up shop in India without doing due diligence. We would like to reiterate here, however, that we have the utmost respect for the Indian Parliament, and it's just a few MPs that are giving it a bad name.